But the one that kind of just like got me right in the heart was one of the women looked at me and kind of raised an eyebrow and said, "So it's basically a scooter." Hello, Internet. Welcome to the channel. I am Gina, otherwise known as Ginger Dash. I decided to make this video so that you would have some understanding about why I decided to buy the bike that I'm riding right now. I purchased a 250cc motorcycle for my first motorcycle, and I've gotten a lot of flack over that from certain individuals. And if you read enough forums or watch enough videos on YouTube comparing motorcycles of a similar engine size, they will all tell you that this bike is gutless, that this bike is not worth buying. But I think that all has to do with what it is you're looking to get out of a motorcycle, and also how much money you have to spend. There were really several different factors that went into why I chose this bike. And I'm gonna boil them down to the main three. So the main three decision-making points for me were, number one, I wanted a full-size motorcycle. And by that, I mean I didn't want a Grom or something of that type. I wanted a motorcycle that, even if it was on the lower end power-wise, it was still a quote-unquote full-size motorcycle. The second thing that was important to me, or essential for me, was that it be a brand new motorcycle. I did not want to buy someone else's problems. And you just never know when you get a used motorcycle or a used car or anything else like that, what you're getting. And it was important for me to feel as if I was getting a machine that was ready to go. And the third most important thing for me to consider when I was buying this motorcycle, or any motorcycle, was cost. Fortunately for me, the Rice Burners Crotch Rockets, the foreign-made motorcycles, tend to start out at a lower price point than your domestic motorcycles like Harleys and such. I didn't buy this bike specifically because it was a beginner bike, although I think it's probably a good or a good enough bike to start out on if you have zero experience as a rider, which was me. That was me. I had no experience. I had never actually operated a motorcycle. So this bike for me was perfectly adequate to learn on. So back to that, do I regret buying a 250? No. However, I do wish I had a motorcycle with more power, but I don't regret buying the motorcycle that I'm currently riding because it's paid for. So if it's not already completely obvious, I am all about the money. Meaning I am thrifty. I don't want to go into debt. I've been there once in my life, and it took me 10 years to dig myself out of it. Over one decision, I have been an incredibly responsible person when it comes to finances, but I made one erroneous choice that cost me debt, and I didn't want to put myself in that predicament again. And I'm glad that I didn't, because 6 weeks after I bought this bike, our state was in lockdown and people started losing their jobs not long after. And for me, while I didn't lose my jobs, and yes, plural, I didn't lose my jobs, but I did lose a big chunk of income, and that income was what I had planned to use to purchase my bike. But anyway, I'm going to stop harping on money. The point here is that everyone has an amount of money or an amount of credit that they're willing to take out to achieve something, whether that's to buy a house, to buy a car, or to buy a motorcycle. And so that's only something you can decide. For me, I made the best choice for me, and that meant I couldn't afford to buy anything more than what I'm currently riding. Does that mean I want to stay on this bike forever? No. As I like to say, the takeaway here is you have to ride your own ride. You have to make your own decisions. Don't allow someone else to tell you what an acceptable bike to start on is. Forget the blog posts. Forget the YouTube videos that compare motorcycles. Oh, this one's better. This one's crap. You know what? If it's on two wheels, I don't care if it's a scooter or a Hayabusa. Whatever works for you. So if you are willing, oh, that's pretty. So if you are willing to spend X amount of money, then get the bike that you can afford based on that amount of money. If you have never ridden a bike, I do not suggest starting out on a large CC motorcycle unless you are the most responsible driver alive. And I use driver because if you're good in a car and you're extraordinarily safe and you're conscientious and you know that you have to be really careful on a higher CC bike when you will tend to jerk the throttle because it's brand new to you, then fine, start on something bigger. But again, that's still just my opinion. I'm just giving you advice based on my experience. And so from my experience, starting out on a 250 was great, especially under all of the circumstances, because it means I don't have any debt right now for this. I have all of the gear that I need. I was able to purchase all of those things. And it still gets me where I want to go. It still gives me the ability to go out and enjoy gorgeous, sunny Florida days, of which this is not one. This is not a beautiful, sunny Florida day. This is an overcast, chilly Florida day. But you know what? I'll take it because I'm still out here and I'm still enjoying the ride. As for the future, what does that hold? I don't know. I would like to have a bigger bike. By bigger, I mean a larger engine. I don't know that I would be satisfied long-term with a Ninja 400, although I think had I purchased that instead of this, I think I would have been happier with it longer than I am happy with this or would be happy with this. However, I could see myself on something in the 600, 700 cc range and be perfectly happy. And I'm talking about sport bikes because I know that cruisers, Harleys, and things of that nature, a lot of them have, you know, some serious kick to them, but they're also twice as heavy as this. I think the type of bike that you choose to purchase has a lot to do with what you're going to do with it. Do you plan to get on the highway? Do you plan to make long trips? You know, do you only plan to kind of commute through town? All of those things are factors to consider when you buy a motorcycle. And also, just something to throw out there, it doesn't matter what anyone else thinks about the bike you buy or are considering buying. And the reason I mention that is because I had bought my bike and I hadn't told anybody about it. I was kind of keeping it on the down low. And I finally was ready to kind of say, oh, hey, you know, I did this to a few friends slash acquaintances. And the reactions were like all over the place. But the one that kind of just like got me right in the heart was one of the women looked at me and kind of raised an eyebrow and said, so it's basically a scooter. So I call it a scooter. Call it whatever you want. I don't care. To me, it allows me to get out and experience the freedom of two wheels, so I'll take it. Hopefully some of the things that I said here were helpful for you. And if nothing else, at least you know what my process was like and some things perhaps to consider if and when you might decide to go buy your first bike. If you would be so kind as to like, comment, and or subscribe, that would be awesome. I would appreciate it very much. I am still getting my feet under me as far as motovlogging is concerned. Editing is still a bit of a challenge. I'm learning a little bit more every time. So to each and every one of you, thank you so much for sticking around to the end. Thank you for possibly being a subscriber, dropping a like or a comment, or even just watching the video all the way to the end. I appreciate it. I truly do. Until next time.